Welcome to an introduction to vectors in space or in 3D. The goals of this video are to determine the component form of a vector in space, determine the magnitude of a vector in space, and also to determine a unit vector in space. I think a good place to start is to take a look at the graph of a vector in 3D. So here we have the XYZ coordinate system, and in blue here we have the graph of a vector, where its initial point is at the origin, 0, 0, 0, and the terminal point is at 3, 1, 5. So we rotate the coordinate system, you can get a better idea of the location of this blue vector. And this is an example of a vector in space. And of course, as we change the terminal point of this vector, its location moves. And now we can see the vector is below the xy plane, as we see here. This is also called a position vector because its initial point is at the origin, 0, 0, 0. A lot of times if we're asked to graph a vector in space on our paper, it's helpful to draw a box to give it a better perspective in 3D. Okay, so for a vector in space, with initial point x1, y1, z1, and terminal point x2, y2, z2, the unique position vector v can be found by subtracting the x-coordinates, y-coordinates, and z-coordinates, resulting in what's called the position vector ABC. Notice the special notation that we use here. They're pointed brackets to represent a position vector. So this means that the initial point is at the origin, 0, 0, 0, and the terminal point would be ABC. One more thing I want to mention here. To note a vector, you can either use a lowercase letter in bold, or if you don't have the option of using bold print, you can use the letter V with a little vector or little arrow above it. The magnitude or length of a vector in space, or R3, is very similar to the magnitude of a vector in R2, except now we have to take the square root of the sum of the squares of the x, y, and z components. And then in order to find a unit vector in the direction of vector v in space, we need to divide the original vector v by the magnitude, or multiply the vector by 1 over the magnitude. That'll result in a vector with the same direction that has length or magnitude of 1. Let's talk a little bit more about unit vectors. I is the unit vector 1, 0, 0, or the unit vector along the positive x-axis. Vector j, 0, 1, 0, is a unit vector along the y-axis. And vector k, 0, 0, 1, is a unit vector along the positive z-axis. And with these vectors, I, j, and k, we can rewrite any vector as a sum or difference of these unit vectors. So for example, if we have the position vector ABC, we can rewrite it as a sum or difference of I, j, and k as A times vector I plus B times vector j plus C times vector k. Let's go and take a look at some sample problems. Let's start by plotting the position vector 2, 3, 4 on the XYZ coordinate system. Remember, this is the x-axis. Let's go and extend it in the negative direction. This would be the y-axis. This is the positive y-axis. This would be the negative y-axis. And this is the z-axis, and this would be the negative z-axis. So this vector has its initial point at the origin and its terminal point at the point 2, 3, 4. Let's go ahead and plot the point 2, 3, 4. So I'll move out 2 units in the positive direction along the x-axis, 3 units in the positive direction along the y-axis, and from here we'll construct a parallelogram in the xy plane. So it looks something like this. And from here we have to go up 4 units along the z-axis. So let's go ahead and go to the z-axis and go up 4 units. And then from here we're going to go ahead and construct a box to give it a better perspective. So let's go ahead and draw an edge here that's parallel to the x-axis, and then go ahead and connect it down. And then we'll draw another edge here that's parallel to the y-axis and down. And now we can go ahead and complete this box by completing the top of the box, something like this. So the point 2, 3, 4 is this point here at that corner of the box. And so the vector we want to sketch starts at the origin and terminates at that point. So it looks something like this. It's a little cramped, but you can kind of see that this does give it a perspective of three dimensions. Now we're given a vector in space with initial point 5, negative 1, 1, and terminal point negative 1, 1, 4. We first want to determine the position vector. Remember, the position vector is the vector in the same direction with the same magnitude, but has the initial point at the origin. So to determine the position vector, we'll subtract the initial coordinates from the terminal coordinates. So we'll have negative 1 minus 5, comma, 1 minus negative 1, comma, 4 minus 1. Let's go ahead and simplify this. We'll have negative 6, 2, and 3. This is the position vector. Again, it's the vector that has the same magnitude and the same direction as the given vector, but has the initial point at the origin and terminal point at negative 6, 2, 3. Now that we have the position vector, we can rewrite this vector as a linear combination of vectors I, J, and K. So vector V could be written as negative 6 I plus 2 J plus 3 K. Same vector written as a linear combination of the unit vectors I, J, and K. Now we want to determine the magnitude of vector V. That's going to be equal to the square root of the sum of the squares of each component. So we'll have negative 6 squared plus 2 squared plus 3 squared. Let's go ahead and simplify this. Looks like we'll have 36 plus 4 plus 9. So the magnitude of vector V is equal to the square root of 49, which is equal to 7. So to find the unit vector of vector V, or the vector that has a magnitude of 1 but has the same direction as vector V, that's going to be equal to 1 over the magnitude of vector V times vector V. So we'll have 1 seventh times vector V, negative 6, 2, 3. We'll go ahead and perform the scalar multiplication. So the unit vector for vector V would be negative 6 sevenths, 2 sevenths, and 3 sevenths. We'll go ahead and finish by talking about vector operations in space, or R3. And this is very similar to vectors in R2. If we want to add or subtract vectors in space, we just need to add or subtract the corresponding components. And for scalar multiplication, if we want to find k times vector u, we just multiply k times each component of vector u, as we see here. And since we performed similar procedures in R2, I'm not going to take the time to show examples for this in R3. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.